Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Halloween chocolate icebox cookies. So we'll be making the cookies today, and then in a couple of days I'll have the icing and show you how to ice them in a way that they will remind you of Halloween. Of course we have the chocolate look, and then I'm going to make an orange frosting. So be looking for that in a couple of days, but we're just doing the cookies today. I'm starting with a large mixing bowl, and into that I'm going to put butter. Now, altogether, this is one stick of butter plus 2 tablespoons. So I had it divided out a little bit. It maybe looks strange, but it is one stick, which is 1/2 cup, plus 2 tablespoons. And it should be softened like that so you can work with it. And then we're adding 1 cup of sugar. We're also adding 1/4 cup of brown sugar. And at this point, I'm going to pause and use my electric mixer and get this blended together so that it's all nice and fluffy. And here's what we have after that blending. Looks really nice, and you could go on with this without adding chocolate. And just add the other ingredients and have a very nice butter cookie. So if you're not interested in the chocolate part of it, leave the cocoa out and just put all of the other ingredients in, and it will be a great butter cookie. But we're going on with our next ingredient, being some unsweetened cocoa. This is cocoa powder, and I'm using 1/2 cup. Want it nice and chocolatey. And we have enough sugar in there to counteract the bitterness of chocolate. And I think I'll go ahead and put my 1 teaspoon of vanilla in and blend these together. And here's what we have after scraping down the sides of the chocolatey mix. The next thing is 1 egg, and we'll beat that in. So here's the blend you have after the chocolate is incorporated, and we're going to need some flour. In this smaller mixing bowl, I have 1 3/4 cups all-purpose flour. To that, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon baking soda right here and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. So that's going to make it sort of like self-rising flour, but you need to blend those together with a little spoon. Something like that. Oops, got a little carried away there. And then gradually add it to your original mixture. So I'll just add part of this and then mix it and then keep adding until all of it is in there. And I will show you what I get. Once you get your flour incorporated into your cookie dough, you should be able to handle it very easily like this. If you want to, at this point, you can cover the bowl with plastic wrap and put it in the refrigerator for a couple of hours before you actually work it, because it might be that it wants to be sticking to your hands a little bit because it's at room temperature. But what I plan to do is to make it into 2 logs and wrap them in wax paper and refrigerate them anyway. So I'm not going to start by chilling first, although that would make it easier to work with. I think I can manage to get these into logs. So I'm just going to try to get this in half, and I'll just squeeze it right there where it looks like the center. It doesn't have to be perfect. And take 1/2 and just make it into a roll that I will put over on wax paper. And as I roll this up, and this depends on whatever size you might want, as I roll it up, it will become more circular. Right now it's a little squared off. In fact, it doesn't hurt to kind of get it square on all 4 sides so that they're about even. But bring it back toward an edge, and then just bring up an edge and roll it, trying to smooth out those corners, and it will be in a form like this, which is more like you would expect to see cookies if you were to slice them off. Sorry about my hands looking like this. Now the other one, I think I want to make it into a little bit larger circumference, so it's going to be shorter. The thing is, I hope that Carter will be able to come over and help me finish these cookies, baking them and also frosting them. But I will give him the little roll. I will cut them for him because I don't trust him with a knife. But I will let him place them on the cookie sheet and he can go from there. But I will have this nice and chilled by having it in the refrigerator first. So I'll work on the other piece and make it into probably a roll that is about that big around. I don't know if you can tell, but it won't make as many because they will make bigger cookies. And if you choose to decorate, it's a little bit easier to decorate a bigger cookie than it is a smaller one. So we'll get back to the chilled dough. We'll have two portions here of different sizes, and Carter might be back. I don't know about that. I may have to finish the cookies by myself if his social life takes him away. We're continuing on the making of our Halloween chocolate icebox cookies, and Carter did show up. He got here just a few minutes ago. Hi, Carter. Tell us something special that happened at school today.
Miss Kentucky.
Miss Kentucky came. Well, did you get to speak to her? Was she pretty?
Beautiful.
I knew she was. Okay, we're going to be making chocolate cookies. And Carter will be in charge of placing these on his pan. And I just want to show everybody what we did to get those after these came out of the refrigerator, having been rolled up in wax paper. You just go down and make a little slice. And as I would say I'm doing a little over a quarter of an inch because these are small. And with mine, which are bigger and are going in a different pan, then I did probably 3/8 of an inch. So I would just go down with a chef's knife. And this is warmed up a little bit, so it's not as controllable as it was when these were really chilled. But Carter's making quite a bit of progress over there, so I guess I better get busy. We want to get these into the oven. So we're putting them on parchment paper. We're just lining a baking pan, each one of us. And we're just putting them spread apart a little bit. Now mine are so large that they probably will run together. And depending on how close Carter has spaced his might run together as well. I'm actually out, so I'm going to move these down a little bit and just have 9 in this pan.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And maybe we'll maintain the shape. Maybe not. It doesn't really matter.
6, 7, 8.
And he's done a nice job of spacing his out.
15.
And you've got 15. All right, let's take these to a 350 degree oven. And it's only going to take about 8 to 10 minutes on his. And mine will be a little bit longer. So we'll come back when both sets are done and show you what we got. Here are our Halloween chocolate icebox cookies. And Carter was a big help by laying these out in the pan. And the ones that are bigger are over here. You want to take a bite of that and see if it's good? Go ahead. It's warm, isn't it?
Good.
You like the flavor?
Mm-hmm.
Is it chocolatey enough?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, yeah. I guess we did pretty well on that. What I would do normally would be place these on a plate, and since these are small, they would only need a small plate. Carter and I will continue on that one in just a minute. And over here, with these being larger, I would put them on a larger plate. So I'll finish these up and you'll get to see both of them.